Well, US lawmakers have played one hell of a move in the ongoing chess game between Uncle Sam and TikTok by giving the Chinese-owned app an ultimatum. Sell TikTok or say goodbye.
The yeas are 352, the nays are 65. The bill is passed.
It's a landmark bill that sent US TikTokers into a spin.
TikTok just got banned.
The TikTok ban passed, and more United States freedoms have been stripped away.
The US House of Reps passing a bill that could see TikTok banned in America.
I think that's unfair.
I think that's insane.
Keep TikTok! Keep TikTok!
This app is so much more than just an app for dumb TikTok dances.
But it wasn't enough to sway the vote. Politicians sending an ultimatum to the app's Chinese-based owner, ByteDance, divest its stakes and sell to a company not based in China within 6 months, or say goodbye to its 170-odd million US users.
This is a national security issue.
TikTok saying,
over the last few years, we have invested to keep your data safe and our platform free from outside manipulation. We have committed that we will continue to do so.
The bill still has to pass the Senate, but it has Biden's backing.
If they pass it, I'll sign it.
Trump, though, has recently flip-flopped to Team TikTok.
We're looking at TikTok. We may be banning TikTok.
Without TikTok, you can make Facebook bigger, and I consider Facebook to be an enemy of the people.
Intelligence officials have long sounded the alarm over TikTok's links to China, fearing Chinese authorities could force ByteDance to hand over user data and weaponize the platform to manipulate users.
Why in the hell would we want and allow the Chinese Communist Party to have access to our private data?
We have yet to receive one piece of public evidence that actually shows that somehow China is actually negatively using our data.
The PM today ruled out following America's lead.
We have made decisions based upon our own security assessments. We're independent. We don't follow other countries.
But the opposition says we should follow suit.
At a time when we're being advised that young people who are using TikTok are having their personal details collected, the Prime Minister has to act. And so far, the Prime Minister hasn't done that.
So could and should TikTok be banned here?
I love you. See you on the other side.
Well, cybersecurity expert Professor Richard Buckland joins us. Professor, should Australia be banning TikTok?
Well, we should certainly be thinking about it. It's a good conversation to have. It's interesting that America's going down that path now, and they've got good reasons for doing so.
Explain it to me, though, Professor. Why is TikTok so dangerous?
There's a couple of reasons. One is they're essentially doing a form of what we call influence or information warfare. With their algorithms, they can see, control what people see. And I guess what makes it particularly dangerous is that the people they're controlling or influencing are children. And this is new. We haven't really seen that. Then there's the China side. We know that China does influence operations more than, say, kinetic warfare, more than, say, Russia does. There are legitimate concerns that TikTok is collecting data on people. And last of all, with this influence that they gather now, they can start to have an effect. And we've seen that with the reaction that they've had to the potential ban is to cause their followers, essentially their users, to rise up and lobby Congress. And I think that's counted against them. That's frightened everyone because it's so clear they can mass armies of people to do things now inside another country. So all of these things added together just make them a risk.
Richard, just in terms of the data and kids, it feels like when you're talking about kids, the data, they might think, oh, it doesn't matter. All of our data's out there anyway. Why should kids particularly care about the data that TikTok collects about them?
I guess we've seen lots of stories about people doing and saying things when they're young, which is supposed to be a time of experimentation, and you go through thinking various crazy things, and it can be used against them when they're older. And we're now in a world where there is no real forgetting. So the things that people do and say when they're children will be remembered when they're adults. There was an interesting story years ago. The FBI used to let children into the school excursions into the FBI headquarters in their local one to get their fingerprints taken, and they could see how fingerprint taking worked. But then the FBI kept all that data, and they now have a huge database of American citizens' fingerprints. This is data, when collected, can look innocent and innocuous, but combined with other data in the future, can be used against you. So, yeah, I guess there's just, it's unknown and it's valuable, and that's why they're doing it. So I think it's right that we're now just asking questions and being a bit cautious.
But the huge amounts of data, this is common to
pretty much all social media applications, right? I mean, we've seen with Facebook, the Cambridge Analytica scandal, where Facebook data was used to try to campaign for Donald Trump in the 2016 election. We've seen other studies where they managed to manipulate Facebook users' emotions. Like, why is it any worse when it's TikTok as opposed to an American company like Facebook?
So I guess the main difference with Facebook, which you're right, does collect a lot of information that's disturbing, is that this is targeted at children, whereas children are increasingly regarding Facebook as perhaps a place for older people. And it's China rather than America. And, of course, America has Facebook is subject to American law and China isn't. And probably in Australia we should be cautious of all other countries' applications. And in terms of data collection, TikTok collects much richer data than Facebook does because they're able to see what you watch and how long you watch it, and there's an enormous flow of information coming through so they can run constant experiments and adjust what they're showing in a way that Facebook can't.
Richard, thank you so much for your time and persevering, because it looks like they put a national park in the middle of a race car track. Yeah. So thank you so much.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.